people. Hello guys, how you doing? Hope you're fine. Oh god, no time, long time, long time no see. Okay, quick one. My name is Isabella Amaka Juliet Chibunna. Yes guys, and my profession is I'm a writer, an author, a creative and a senior entrepreneur. Yes guys, I'm a content creator, events planner, precisely project planning, and I'm an actor, a filmmaker, and lots more. So classify everything, which I'm a polymath. Okay guys, I'm the CEO of Isabella's Production Nigeria Limited. Are you excited? Founder of Mark Isabella Empowerment Foundation and the CEO of Issa Culture by Isabella's. We are launching soon. 28% loaded. Yes, guys. Okay, back to business. Okay, guys, and I'm excited to be here and I'm sure that you're excited to see me. Okay, back to business. Okay, back to business. Welcome to the new season, the new series precisely tagged Catching Up with our book. Guys, welcome to this new series tagged Catch Up with the Book Summary for my readers. Yes, guys, and this very series is hosted by Isabella's Books in partnership with Isabella's Talk Show. You can see I am rocking up the t-shirt. Isabella's Talk Show. Isabella's Talk Show. Think big, start small. You can see, guys. Yes, guys. And welcome once again to this beautiful series. Okay, a very quick one. The name of the book I am going to be presenting on as one of your reader in this very episode. And this episode is episode 5. I can't wait for you guys to see this beautiful video. I'm gonna be, and I am going to be expressing myself as a reader. One thing is to be a writer, another thing is to be a reader. So when you're a reader, you can flow and understand the tactics of the writer. Okay, guess what? The name of this book I am presenting on is, guess, The Cracked Love. I am presenting on The Cracked Love. Yes, guys, I am presenting on The Cracked Love. And this book is written or authored by no other person than Isabella Amaka Juliet Chibunna. You've been saying, why is she blushing? Because I am the Isabella Amaka Juliet Chibunna. Okay, guys, back to business. Right now, I am going to be talking about on my... Should I do that? Okay, I'm gonna do it. I was discussing with you about my favorite characters. Yes guys, and I'm going to talk about, okay guys, so in this very episode I am going to be discussing with you on few things, and one of them is my favorite characters in this book, and I'm also going to be shortlisting these characters. When I shortlist, I talk about it, and also my favorite chapters and the page. So welcome once again to this very serious tact, Catch Up with the Book Summary from our readers. Okay guys, a quick one. Okay guys, in The Cracked Love, we have about 11 characters in this very book. Yes guys, and those 11 characters are, number one, Tasha, Olivia, Mr. and Mrs. Ikoko, Bankole Baju, Mike's mother, Mimi, Mali, Mr. Johnson, Olutope, aka Mama T, and Olivia's mother. So guys, these are the characterization. You can see them. So now I'm going to be talking about my favorite character. My favorite character in this play is Tasha. I love Tasha so much because of her generosity, her hospitality, should I say go-getting vibes, something like that, okay? And my other favorite character is Bankole Baju. Do you know why I love Bankole Baju? Because one thing about me, I love sincere people, I love honesty, and I like men that know what they want and they go for it without wasting time. And I love men that stand on their own motive. Like, I love men that are diplomatic and they believe in themselves. They don't let people to take decision for them. If they want this, they go for this. And I love the fact that Bankole Baju is a guy with principle, a guy with determination, and so humble. It takes a humble guy, it takes a responsible guy to see a lady with potential even when she's not up to that class. It takes a lot for a guy to detect that. So let's go on. Okay, right now let me introduce something to you, something spicy. Tasha, she's kind, generous, simple, open-hearted, and lovable. While Bankole Baju, he's smart, like I said, kind and focused. He's a go-getter, but contented with what he has and with whom he is cutting with. That's why I love him. And when I was writing this book, I so much love this character, and I took my time to express everything about him. I took my time to express everything about Bankole Baju. I took my time for people to know that such kind of people or such kind of men are in existence. So it's just for you to put your head up. And also be smart to detect them when they come around. So that one is a topic for another day. Let's go back to the business for today. Okay, apart from Bankole Baju and Tasha, I think I love Olivia. I love Olivia because she's kind, caring, motivating, but also a non-nonsense person. I think I can relate with this because some of my personalities surrounding this. Olivia got some of my potentials. Yes, guys, she has no conscience for her enemies. She prefers her enemies to die than to live. Wow, so that is Olivia for you. So I think you need to get this book to understand why she preferred her enemies to die than to live. Get this book and figure out why Olivia did that. If her actions or her personality, it's okay, then we'll talk about it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, guys, so these are my favorite characters. So what I am going to be doing right now, I want to talk about my favorite chapters and pages. So join me as I take you down there. Okay, guys, and my favorite chapter is chapter 5. And it's everyone. Like, this is my favorite chapter, chapter 5. And it's everyone. I read. And this everyone is on chapter 5, page 29, and tagged everyone. Thank you. 1 month later, Tasha made preparations to travel to Lagos, Olivia assisting her. Soon, They left for the park. When they got there, just one vacant seat was left to fill. So Thatcher hurried to the booking clerk and bought her ticket. Once that was sorted out, she went to Olivia and hugged her goodbye. Thatcher, I am going to miss you, Olivia. Please take care of yourself and put me in your prayers always. I need to adjust. Olivia, I will, my best friend. I am going to miss you too. Thatcher boarded the vehicle and the driver drove off. Olivia stood there, waving a long time until the vehicle was out of sight. When Thatcher arrived at the city of Lagos, she thought it was highly developed and beautiful, and that it was indeed the center of excellency. Okay. Thatcher went to a business center, brought out her diary, and gave a number to a young attendant. He dialed the number, but unfortunately, the line was not existing, said a voice from the telecoms company. Scared and confused, she left the business center, walked away, and kept walking, having no definite destination in mind. Yeah. She was still walking along the road when she saw a notice board that read, "Receptionist needed. If you are interested, call the number below." Impulsively, she brought out her diary, copied the number, and rushed to a business center. She gave the business center attendant the diary and pointed to the number she wanted to dial. The woman dialed it and the call connected. Someone picked the call and Thatcher introduced herself to the person on the other end. When they were done talking, she paid for the call and asked the attendant for a pair. Forgetting she had one in her bag that she used only a few minutes before, she took the pen and wrote down the address of the hotel the attendant, who was no more than 2 years older than Thatcher, but carried herself like a woman in her 50s. Knowing what just happened, decided to offer Thatcher a word of advice. Interesting. Attendant, speaking in Nigeriana Pidgin English. "Please, I beg, make you not vex so. I been at work, you dey fine." I'm translating down to English. "Please pardon me for concerning myself with what should not be my business. What is it, a job you're searching for?" Thatcher replied. She said, "Yes." Attendant, "I beg, when you reach there, make you open your eyes, oh. Shine now, well, well. Lagos now big place, oh. And the kind thing where they see for here, not be small. Shebi, you get full." I'm translating down to English. "Please, when you get there, make sure your eyes are wide open and your antennas are full on alert. Lagos is big. Do you have a phone?" Thatcher smiled. "It's a long story, but to cut it short, I sold my phone in order to get here." Attendant, "Ah, it is well, you. Many, many people like you, way down they like your condition. Come Lagos and small time life come better for them. Make this Lagos where you come so good for you. Lagos go better for you." Translation. "So many people who were in similar condition as yours or worse have experienced transformation in their lives after coming to Lagos. May this Lagos that you have come to be good for you." Thatcher, "Amen. Thank you. What is your name?" Let me adjust. I so much love this part. "Attendant, my name is Olutope. but you can call me Mama T for short. Tasha, letting out a little giggle. Okay, Mama T, dear, you are funny. Attendant, why would they laugh at me? Why are you laughing at me? Tasha, I'm not laughing at you. Your nickname is funny, like I like it. That's why I laughed. Attendant, okay, wait till be your own name. What is your name? What is your own name? Tasha, my name is Tasha, but you can also call me T for short. Well, I'm not so much. Attendant, blinking her eyes faster, having one hand on her waist, at the same time shaking her head, shoulders and waist from side to side. Ah, no, not only me them they call Mama T, no one else. I'm the only one they call Mama T, no one else. Anyway, I will call you Tasi for short. I will call you Tasi for short. Tasha, finding everything humorous, laughs. Okay, you can do all that and call me whatever you want, but my name is Tasha. Attendant, Lagos Bigo, you need to travel smart to stay this Lagos, but no fear, Lady Tasi. God way they help people with challenges for this Lagos will help you too. You need not to fear. The same God who has helped others who were once in your situation like yours will help you too. Wrapping up her pep talk, she wrote her number on a piece of paper and gave it to Tasha with some friendly words. Attendant, take this number in case you reach there and you not get where to sleep. Call me with this number, I will come carry you with my moto. No worry yourself, take this number. If you get there and you can't find a place to sleep, call me, I will come and get you. Don't bother about anything. Tasha keeping the number in her handbag. Thank you. Okay, Mama T, I'm leaving. The woman brought out Tasha's money and gave it back to her. Attendant, take this money when you take pay for the call. Add them to your transport fare. As you they go, this na Lagos. Shine your eyes well, well. Yeah, no be Abuja, oh. Yeah, na Lagos. Center of see me, see you. When I was writing this particular page, I was laughing. I was so laughing. And I think I can remember vividly throughout that week, that was just my slang, like center of see me, see you. Okay. I'm going to translate to English. Take back the money with which you paid me for the call. Add it to your transport fare. I urge you again to be very careful. Keep your eyes wide open. This is not Abuja, but Lagos, center of see me, see you. Tasha, thank you. I'll be very careful. She left Mama's tea shop, saw a commercial bus going to the highland, and boarded it. After a few minutes in the bus, Tasha's mind did a very flashback, and she remembered some words that Olivia said to her. Do you want to know what Olivia said to her? So guys, what are you waiting for? Go and get your own copy. The name of this book, sorry, is The Crack Love. It's interesting. If my reading is not smooth, well, you're going to love what I put into this book. It's so interesting from chapter 1 down to chapter 1 down to chapter 10. The book is interesting, and the chapter 10 is ending with weeping. Beautiful book, and this book contains lots of moral lessons and love quotes. Yeah, my quotes. I love this book so much. So guys, apart from this book, you can still get other collections of Isabella's books. Yes guys, we have The Cat and the Dog, we have Bimpe and the Witch Man. Yes guys, and the least but not the last, Invasion. Are you a businessman? Are you a businesswoman? Do you want to go into entrepreneurship and you don't know how to start? Are you in, or are you already practicing entrepreneurship but you don't know how to go about those challenges, those critical moments of finances, how to get, take a huge risk to get your business going even when you lack resources? Get this book. This book is so beautiful, filled with diverse and vital information about entrepreneurship, waiting to encourage you guys. I poured out my whole heart when writing this. So guys, this is all you can see and Isabella's books. And if you want to get this book, you can get it through our social media page on Instagram for now. And our Instagram handle is Isabella's Books. I'm going to spell it Isabella Books. Yes, guys, thank you for shopping. Thank you for shopping with us in advance. And those of you that have already shopped, I love you guys. Keep sending your review. And guess what? Yes, guys, we are storing up on our next episode. Keep watching. Catch up with the book summary from our readers. And my name still remains Isabella Amaka Juliet Chibunna, aka Issa Girl, aka Sipun Classic. And guess what? A quick one. I can never end this video without doing some little advertisement. Guess what? I am going to be launching my cloth line anytime soon. 28% loading. And please follow us up on our Instagram page, Issa_Culture, and the name of my fashion or cloth line brand is Issa Culture by Isabella's. I am the CEO of Issa Culture by Isabella's. I can't wait for you to see my trends. With Issa Culture, you can portray royalty as your true image. Bye-bye. Thank you.